challenge was my way of this statement is on the other side. That's what we're going to talk about today. It's on the other side. Let's look at 31. I'm going to read 31. I'll be reading from the King James, Matthew chapter 14. And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand. This is right after Peter failed. Peter had gotten out of the boat and began walking on the water and got distracted. And all of us can identify with getting distracted. All of us can associate with that, can actually see that when you're doing what God would have you do, your eyes are on Jesus, things are going well, you're going to be distracted. And he allowed it, the distraction to cause him to take his eyes off of Jesus. One of the most thorough prayers, one of my favorite, that is in 2 Chronicles chapter 20 and verse 11 and 12, is when Jehoshaphat prays to God, and he says to God, "We don't know what to do, and we don't have the power to do what we need to do, and we are outnumbered. We don't know what to do, we don't have the power to do what we need to do, and we are outnumbered." This is what Jehoshaphat says, even though we don't know what to do. We are outnumbered and we don't have the power to do what we need to do. Our eyes are on you. I mentioned this a few times. Our eyes are on you. And Peter failed because he took his eyes off of Jesus. But the beauty of the following is that he was so close to Jesus that the text says immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him. And let me tell you, that you will never fail. You will never fail staying where you are. Staying where you are. If you don't take a risk, if you're not willing to take a risk, if you're not willing to step out, if you're not willing to, if you're not willing to try, don't worry about it. You won't fail. People criticize Peter for falling. But he gave you out of the boat. He did take a risk. As a matter of fact, Jesus kept it. And he did sink, as the Bible says, at the beginning of sinking. When you get on water, you don't begin to sink, you sink. Can I get a good witness right here? Amen. I said, can I get a good witness right here? Now, this is on the other side. In verse 22 of our text, the Bible says that Jesus, in the King James, Jesus constrained the disciples. He made them get in the boat. And the reason why he made them get in the boat, not just to send them to the other side, but the disciples were playing into what the people were doing. This text follows the fact that Jesus had fed 5,000 plus people, and in performing this great feat, in performing this great victory, the people wanted to hold on to Jesus and wanted to make him a king. And the disciples are buying into that. The disciples said, "Jesus, go ahead on and accept it. Go ahead on now. And as a follow on, and that put a crown on your head." They were trying to make Jesus king. They were trying to make Jesus king before it was time for him to be king. And you have to watch people who are always trying to push you, let you do what it's all about God's timing. And Jesus, the Bible says, Jesus was a strong way. He constrained his disciples. He forced them. Y'all get in the boat. They followed Jesus. They did what Jesus told them to do. They are what they're supposed to be, doing what they're supposed to be doing, on their way to where Jesus told them to go, and yet a storm came. They're in compliance, they're not rebellious, they think in the good, they are going forth, and they're moving forward, and they're rowing, and they're headed toward the place where Jesus told them to go. And yet a storm came. They didn't turn around and go back in the other direction. They're still going and rowing and moving in the direction that Jesus, as a matter of fact, they are what they are because Jesus told them. As a matter of fact, he forced them to be there, and they are what they are, and yet a storm came. Isn't it interesting that you can be what you're supposed to be, do what you're supposed to be doing, listen to the Lord praying, and things are together, and yet guess what happens? A storm.
You can't see it, but I see it. I don't see it in my natural eye.
tempted, it will come all right before y'all are hooked up. Yeah, see, yeah, you don't understand him. You don't understand him. See, what we're going through right now, you didn't understand. It's one for the bottom of the flight, two for the tip down of the flight. We're just going to double up on you. Wish I had somebody here. We're doubling up on you here. We're going through a little something right now, but we're doubling up on you, you see. Yeah, you don't understand. In the next few months, you're going to really be ambushed. Because you think we're going down. You think we're going down. You think we're going to be defeated. You think we're going to give up. And just a few more days, you don't want us to have a bad time. You don't want us to be disappointed. You don't want us to be ambushed. And it's not going to be up. We're going to turn out for another shopping push.
I hope you remember that because
Would you agree that $25 in the bank is a little money? Okay, a little money, that's a little money. He's agreeing. The $25 in the bank, in your bank account, is a little money. All right. So, you're out, and y'all doing what y'all do. And you don't have a checkbook. You don't have, and you have your debit or credit card. And you have a little money in the bank. And you don't have no credit card. It's home. You left it and you don't have a check. So you don't have that. That's no. And you got a little money in the bank. That's little. But it's not accessible. That's where. Little things that you can't put your hands on. You got no money in the bank, but you ain't got no check. You ain't got no credit card, which means right now you ain't got no money. Because it's not accessible. I wish I had someone that kind of had me know that's little faith. But if we talk about faith as a grain of mustard seed, let's talk about stored up faith. Mustard seed faith is stored up faith. That means it starts out small, but it doesn't end small.
He didn't stop in the storm. He not tell the storm be quiet. He don't Yeah. Bishop, Bishop.
They came and they kneeled. And Lewis. And then Lewis.
I got your first name, Peter.
Sure. Did you find me the other day on Facebook? Okay. I'm sure Peter. That was all right for me to get to that. Holy Ghost.